It's Sybil Wilkes with What You Need to Know. Today is Tuesday, September 29th, 2020. Number one, a New York Times report has revealed Donald Trump paid no federal income taxes in 10 out of 15 years, beginning in the year 2000, because he reported losing significantly more than he made. In 2016 and 2017, the years he was elected and became president, he paid $750 in federal income tax. Additionally, the report indicates he has debts over $420 million that he has personally guaranteed, and that will be due within the next 4 years. And this has invited a number of concerns regarding the national security of the United States. Number two, last week, Kentucky Attorney General Daniel Cameron announced that no officers would be charged in the shooting death of 26-year-old Breonna Taylor. Since the announcement, the Kentucky State Police Ballistics report of the shooting could not determine that Taylor's boyfriend, Kenny Walker, shot one of the officers, contradicting statements made by Cameron, as well as reports over the last 6 months. Breonna's family and attorneys are calling for the release of all evidence that led to the grand jury's decision to hold no one accountable for this young woman's death. Number three, a recent study funded by the National Institutes of Health finds that people with substance abuse problems such as opioid and tobacco addiction may be more susceptible to contracting and dying from coronavirus. Opioids inhibit the respiratory centers in the brain and slow the breathing rate, making a COVID-19 infection especially deadly. In addition, the use of drugs such as tobacco and cocaine associated with heart problems and high blood pressure, which are common risk factors for coronavirus complications. Number four. As a young boy, Tommy Mabry was kicked out of 10 schools before reaching high school and was arrested for breaking and entering. Today, the doctor and HBCU grad has made empowering others his mission. Read more about Dr. Mabry and his inspiring journey in today's newsletter. Number five, the Securities and Exchange Commission, or the SEC, has expanded its definition of who qualifies as an accredited investor. The amendments will allow more investors to participate based on their knowledge and expertise. Minorities will especially benefit from the opportunity to invest in private offerings because many people worth less than $1 million are capable of sound investing. Join me today live on YouTube and Facebook at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Central with pop culture and entertainment news expert John Murray as we discuss today's top headlines and more. Then tune in tonight, joining my friends George Wallace, Myra J., Stephen Hill, John Murray, and Chris Paul with a live post-analysis of the first Biden and Trump presidential debate. That's what you need to know. For more information, please go to SybilWilkes.com. Sign up for my free newsletter. Be informed. Be empowered.